Hi, I'm Amik Owens, producer of Jonah, a VeggieTales movie. I'd like to show you how we make a CG animated feature film. The first step is the story. Phil Vischer and Mike Naraki wrote the script for Jonah. It's very, very important that we have a good story before we can actually put it into production.
Story is everything. It's the foundation of the movie. Once we have a solid outline, a solid, you know, skeleton of the story down, I'll just, you know, go in and start writing. And from there, it's a, you know, process of discovery, really.
After the story is written, the script is handed out to our storyboard artists. It's their job to describe the action that's happening in the script on paper by drawing it kind of like a comic book.
Story takes the script and they visualize that story onto storyboards. They work very hard at trying to bring life visually into that story and to make it work. Where it was once written word on a page, now it has to be a visual.
It's very similar to doing a comic strip or a comic book. It's a sequential art. You have to tell, you know, one picture at a time to tell a story. So we have to do a lot of drawings, do them very quickly and very clearly. Your drawings have to read, they have to be clear. All the emotion, all the action, all the comedy has to be there in a single drawing.
After they've drawn the storyboards, they have to actually get up and pitch them to the rest of the creative team. This is where they sell their gags and the little funny parts that they've come up with.
The pitch is really an opportunity to get our ideas and present them to the director. It's kind of performance art because the director's going to be looking at the drawings, but you're also sort of acting out and timing the boards as you're going along. And you know, if you're going to do the character voices because you really want to get the directors where they're really seeing the movie the way that you're trying to show it to them.
While the storyboard artists are working on the pacing of the film, our visual development team is working on the look of the picture, starting with a blank sheet of paper with pens, pencils, or paint, and they're designing the sets, the props, and the characters.
Our visual development team actually does thousands of drawings. Drawings of props, characters, backgrounds, still done by hand, two-dimensionally. What hat should Larry be using? What does Cleo look like? All that is drawn out. There might be 20 different variations, and we're putting all those different variations together to create the final piece that you see.
Then we record the voices for the movie. Our actors have to have great imaginations. We put them in this tiny recording booth with a microphone and script. That's all. Their great performances inspire our animators to bring our characters to life.
You essentially have to see the film in your head and picture the scene in your head. Voiceover sessions are hilarious, and they have been from the beginning. It's really fun. We're usually laughing if we're not crying.
With the storyboards drawn and the voices recorded, we then go to editorial to create the story reel. This is where we actually get to see our movie come together for the first time.
Usually it's like post-production. It comes at the end when you go shoot your footage. You come down to editing and edit together. In animation, it's totally different. You edit in the front. You nail down the timing for each and every shot, and then you give this information to the rest of the studio.
While the other steps are taking place, our modeling team has taken the 2D artwork from our visual development team and has started creating our sets and our props and our characters in 3D space.
As the concept department showed you a lot of their sketches, you know, that's what we get. And then in the computer, we will begin to build a wireframe model based on that. And that's the first phase of it, and then the texturing, the detail, the coloring.
This is where our layout department comes in. They take the 3D sets, characters, and props and place a virtual camera in the space to see how our story plays out in a 3D environment.
They're the cinematographers. They're the guys with the cameras that put everything in the perfect spot.
With our camera set and a space to work in, it's our animators' turn to bring the characters to life. In a 3D animated feature, the animators are really the actors. They listen to the voiceover talent that had been recorded and decide how our characters should move and react.
We're taking inanimate objects, objects that normally wouldn't move, and breathe in a personality. We work the face, the eyes, the mouth, and the body language.
Two steps that help drive the feel of the movie are lighting and music. The lighting department is one of the last departments in the pipeline. They take the final elements and help create the mood that you see on the big screen by painting the set with lights.
We use virtual light, which is similar to real light, and we have directional lights and spotlights and similar, you know, terms, but we don't get the same like bounce light and type. We have to fake that. So that's why it's more like a painting process where we're able to add like highlights or shadows and tweak things however we want, so it's more of like an illustrative process.
Our effects team also helps put the finishing touches on the film by doing smoke, fire, rain, and water. And we had a lot of water in Jonah.
Visual effects are kind of fun because they're like the little visual details that really tie what you're doing into the scene and the things that are happening in the scene. So besides the water and the spray and the wake, we also have things like when a van goes around a corner, we need to have dust get kicked off the side of the road. We have a scene where a van goes over the side of a hill and it needs to have kind of like leaves going over the side of the hill with it and all the dust that goes along with that. Things like fire always take into place. So you have candles and a couple places you have torches that are all considered visual effects.
Once the shots are lit and the effects are done, the shots are sent off to hundreds of computers by a team of render wranglers.
Our form of rendering in computer animation is the thing that allows all of the various things that we've sort of defined mathematically in computer animation software to be rendered visible. So all of the construction of the model in 3D space, the surface attributes that have been assigned, all the textures, the lighting that goes on them, we couldn't see any of that if we didn't render them out.
As the studio is wrapping up the visuals of the film, the composer's writing the music. The music is crucial to the feeling and emotion of any movie.
We've written the songs for the movie, but on top of that, we've got to write the score. That's all the music that doesn't have any lyrics. It's the music that brings the emotion to a scene. Are we scared? What sort of music do we hear? Are we happy? We need to hear some happy music. So we need to bring the score into the picture now.
With the music written, it's time to call in the musicians and record the score.
We recorded in Seattle in what used to be a sanctuary. And so it was so fun to work in this environment and finally hear what we've been hearing on synthesizers and on pianos for months and months being brought to life by an orchestra.
The audio mixers then take the three sound elements, the score, the dialogue, and the sound effects, and blend them together to match the visuals of the film.
You've got a big screen in front, you've got the surround speakers, just like in a theater. You've got a lot of space to work with so you can hear what it's going to sound like in a theater. So we just sat there for a week mixing different elements. Not only did we have the orchestra, but we recorded extra strings, and then we recorded ethnic percussion and ethnic strings and the choir and a piano here and there.
If you really like music, there's a whole nother DVD feature on the music of Jonah. Well, that's it for me. I hope you've enjoyed this little tour through our studio and the process of making a CG animated feature film. Until next time.